Yeah, the district shut down the school today because they weren't sure whether the police would be finished processing the crime scene. But you can see today it's clear and calm on campus. A different story last night.
So it's just unfortunate that people are so selfish and think they're tough and big and bad and just could just shoot whenever they please.
Alexis Gulick was inside Sheridan High School Tuesday night for a volleyball game when a verbal altercation between two teen boys spilled into the parking lot and ended in gunfire.
I actually did hear some bullets. It was like doo, 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 doo.
Police say the 15 and 16-year-old kids had a previous beef with each other. One, who attends an alternative school in the Sheridan School District, pulled out a gun, shooting the other, who attends school in Denver, in the shoulder. Police say they're still looking for the suspect.
I think the message to him is he needs help, to get help and to reach out. If that include, I think that does include turn yourself in and let's get to the bottom of the problem.
Sheridan School Superintendent Pat Sandoz says he's saddened by the violence. An armed robbery that ended with a shooting outside the school a few years ago prompted the district to step up security. It's believed to be the first in the state to have a shooter detection system to warn of gunshots inside a school. Now Sandoz is considering how to enhance protocols outside the school and at extracurricular events.
We want to ensure our kids are safe. We have great security at our events. We had folks there. And the inside of the building was very secure. As a matter of fact, we locked down.
Alexis Gulick, meanwhile, who stayed in the building during the gunfire, says she's lucky the situation didn't end up worse.
I just think that they're just disrespectful, selfish people.
The victim attended John F. Kennedy High School in Denver. They had stepped up police patrols today, and that will happen at school here tomorrow at Sheridan, though police don't believe anyone else is in danger. The victim did go through a surgery and is recovering, and so is another girl who was assaulted in the midst of this altercation. I'm Lori Jane Gliha, Fox 31.